We're going to talk about subtotals. We have a range of data here, and it's the sales for a particular company, and it's listed by day, and it's listed by salesperson as well. So what I'd like to do is I'd like to find out the subtotals for each day, how we're doing for each day. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all the data in my range here. And then I'm going to go to the data tab, and under the heading outline, on the outline group, I'm going to go to subtotal. Okay, the subtotal dialog box lets you choose what change do you want to use for making your subtotals. So it has listed all the headings here, but I'd like to choose every time the date changes to do a subtotal. And then it's asking you what you would like to do, and you can do count, average, minimum, maximum, but I would like the sum of these, and so I'm selecting sum. And then it's asking you which field that you would like to total, and so I'm going to select the amount, and then I'm going to say okay. And now if you look at our data, we have subtotals for each of the days. So on the 7th we have 851, on the 8th we have 2072, and then if you look at the bottom, we have a grand total, which is a total of all these subtotals. So that is a quick explanation of how to use the subtotal function. Please subscribe.